What's up, gamers? I'm your host, SportsFan 100. I am the Seahawks. He's the Cardinals. Final game, and better be a good one, because I don't like that I lost to the Patriots. Happy Halloween. Spooky day. Month. Who cares? Final game before the Bruins face off against the Wild, as me and Tom watch the game live at TD Garden. Hopefully, we will not be disappointed.
Hopefully.
Is he doing the dab?
Looks like he's going like,
yeah! Oh. Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, we have two quarterbacks who love to make game-changing plays. It's Richard Sherman going up against Patrick Peterson. And with that, it's off to the Valley of the Sun, Phoenix, Arizona. We'll hand it over to our broadcasting team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Valley of the Sun and University of Phoenix Stadium here in Glendale. Tonight, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the Arizona Cardinals. And hi again, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you take a look at our matchup here. You've got to believe that this is a game that might be won in the trenches.
Oh, without question. This is big person on big person, big unit against big unit.
Meat on meat.
Oh, you got it all. Pick your cliche, but we know this. The ground's going to shake, things are going to rumble, and they're going to have an impact on today's game.
Here's Chandler Catanzaro ready to get this one started. Just about time to rock as Toe gets ready to meet leather. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Trotting onto the field, the 27-year-old Russell Wilson. He'll be in charge for the Seattle Seahawks, and Wilson in the win over the Falcons week 6, 270 yards, no touchdowns, also no picks.
And sometimes that's what it takes to manage a game and win one. And I know a lot of people are used to Russell Wilson also having an effect on a game with his legs, but he's had those injuries in the early going. He's protecting himself right now. When he gets healthy, we'll see that added back into his repertoire.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
The Hawk White shutter.
Well, that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Now Wilson on second down. Complete out right to Kurz. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain. And just like that, it's third down.
Rick.
Here's
wow,
the
offense,
certainly some threats on this offense. And one of them that they target is Doug Baldwin.
Michael Sir.
Nice job catching
Graham.
The ball downfield. He's also a tremendous blocker that helps unleash the running game.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and 8. Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. Surveying the field. He's going to sling this deep downfield. The intended target, Doug Baldwin. Now fourth down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. He's got time in the pocket. And it is incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. Then the Cardinals will now take over with excellent field position. So shall we say a bold decision to go for it, and that bold decision does not pay off.
And when you talk about bold, you're saying all caps?
All caps.
Yeah, without a doubt. Maybe they're telling their defense they have a lot of faith in them. I mean, that's how you have to spin it, is that you tell your defense, you know something? We were able to go for it there because you guys are so good. I'm not worried about things. That's the only explanation I can come up with in this situation.
Well, he better get ready to spin it for that post-game presser because you know he's going to be out.
He's going to have to spin it for his own locker room, frankly.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Now Palmer on first down. And this is Michael Floyd complete. And he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 10 there. And the Cards are going to have a first down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
They go play action here on first down.
Yeah.
Oh, and it's incomplete. That would have been big in the end zone if he could have held on. Instead, it's second down.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off the drive. He had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
Play action. It's Palmer. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety Cam Chancellor. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, they thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range. But boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board. But give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And the 11 defensive starters for Arizona.
Deion Buchanan was drafted as a safety, but makes many of his plays as a linebacker in their scheme.
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Here's Wilson. And left side here, it's Graham. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
Well, partner, Jimmy is no longer down. Jimmy Graham is back and in a big way. How about this past week? Another excellent game, and I believe he's averaging over 100 yards per game in his last 3 outings.
He is indeed, and you're right. 6 catches, 89 yards in week 6. He's back. He's got time. He's going to loft one. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. It's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
Partner, when you're playing cover two, this is like a tag team for the safeties. Each of them gets a half-field responsibility. Their job, stay as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, read the football, and go make a play. In this case, the free safety made the best play, an interception.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. The tight end, Jermaine Gresham, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Oh, well, we didn't get on anything.
Second and 10. It's Palmer again. Looking deep downfield. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
That's a bold strike right there. Taking it downfield and putting some air on it. But how about the coverage? Able to get his hands across the receiver and bat the ball down.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass.
I love him.
Yeah.
Right now, 18.
Off the play fake. Here's Palmer. He's going to let this go deep. Back over the middle. Looking for Floyd, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety Cam Chancellor. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his second interception of the game. And so much of playing defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
After the interception, here's Wilson finding time. He's going to try and go deep again. This is caught.
Why'd you stop?
The 15. A big play that time for the Seahawks. 61 yards.
What a moron.
That
you just
play will
stop.
End up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
Now a play fake here on first down. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. Well, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of just been driving on those paved roads and those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? That's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity bounce to it.
You spent some time on some Tennessee country roads.
I certainly have. Plenty of family back there. God love them.
For Kristen Michael, his fifth year in the league. First 4 years, a total of 497 yards, but now getting a chance in Seattle, 354 through 6 weeks.
I love what he said about the whole thing, about how he had to wake up and realize what he needed to do in his career. And he rededicated himself this year with a second opportunity in Seattle. And boy, it's paying off, not just for him, but for the Seahawks.
And he added two scores to go along with 64 yards in their game against the Falcons in week 6.
That drive was quick and impressive. Almost like they had somewhere else they needed to be after the game.
Steven Hauschka for the point after. And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead.
The Boston will win again. Ready to kick it.
Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. All right, this is a guy that needs no introduction to the league. He has been around quite a while.
And it's good that they have him, because when he looks around his huddle, he may not have guys with the same experience he has. Maybe some of the youngsters, and his veteran leadership should help them along the way.
Yeah, leadership.
Here we go. 1-18.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He's going to take another shot here. And that's caught inside the 30. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21.
I'm going to be carried by Ethan Stone.
Stop. 7-0 is our score. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
The NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Head & Shoulders. Shoulders were made for greatness, not dandruff.
Ready to go.
I think it's called Head & Shoulders because you, like, get the soap ball. Then it, like, goes down your shoulder. It sounds dumb, but I don't know. China Smash! China Smash!
China Smash, you humans.
Jesus Christ. Did the base the plays in the ones that makes this?
Let's go, let's go!
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Here's Palmer to throw. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And they went big on first down. Proves unfruitful.
Tremendous field position there, and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. They went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
Stick Ohio. Zone the drive. Flag or drive. I feel like we're just listing street names.
Here we go.
Second and 10 now. It's Palmer.
Drop.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Michael Floyd. And that'll make it third down.
Under.
So a ways to go here on third and 10.
We're out here. We're
here we go.
On third down, Palmer. surveying the field, looking for the end zone. That one was intended for John Brown, and it's fourth down. So, partner, they took a shot, just didn't pan out.
I like their aggressiveness, just unable to come down with it downfield.
And Catanzaro's kick is right through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So three drives now for this offense, and that field goal gives them their first 3 points.
Yeah, as an offensive coordinator, if you're averaging a point a drive, you're in the wrong line of work. But in his defense, this has been a stifling defense so far. So they've got to start finding a way to unlock
this.
This
is the point where we fuck around.
So many times during the course of the game, Brandon, the special teams actually helps out their offense. Not in this case. They did them zero favors with that return.
The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield. Yeah, to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bouncing out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third. So they test out the secondary with a deep ball, but the defense wins this round.
And everything looked right. Beautiful throw, just unable to connect.
Wilson, he's going to go up top again.
What the fuck are we doing?
And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down.
The name of the game is always on defense. Put pressure on the quarterback. And that's exactly what they've done today. It looks like they've got him a little bit rattled. That would have been the second interception in the first half.
The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on fourth and 10. They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. He's going to let it go again. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. It's a big-time play there.
No, I knew what you did.
42 yards. On first and 10, it's Wilson. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Now that we've got a second, need to ask you about Carolina. 1-5 through six games.
Did not expect that at all, especially because of their defense. And so far in 2016, the defense has struggled a little bit. How about Cincinnati?
Yeah, 2-4.
The way they lost the playoff game, we didn't know if it would affect them or not. Maybe it has, but they still have a chance to make a big run in their division. But San Diego, I know no one's really talking about them, but the way they lost their four games, absolute heartbreakers, maybe they can put a run together by Philip Rivers. Well, surprise, surprise, partner. No, we know it's not a surprise. When you try to complete a pass against this Cardinals defense, there's a reason that they are known as the no-fly zone.
So out now come the Cardinals. To throw is Palmer. And he can't get away from the pressure. Palmer sacked. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
Now Palmer to throw on second down. He's going to float this one deep right side. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Cardinals. Michael Floyd, 67 yards. And the Cardinals have retaken the lead. And that there, that was just a fly route. There was no stop. He just went.
Yeah, and it was beautiful to watch because you have to set it up as you go along. Everyone knows he's fast, so you play him for that. That's the number one thing you want to take away. But as you go through a game, sometimes you vary the speed in which you come off the line of scrimmage and maybe start a little bit slower, get him to stop his feet a little bit as a defensive back, and then explode and go, as we saw there.
And he is out of bounds here on the return. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Larry Ridley in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Now Wilson. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Frosty Rocker able to get in there and take
jokes
him down
on you,
for
I don't
a
give
loss
a shit.
Three. And the offense now will try to regroup after the sack on second down. A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this third and eight. He's going to float this one deep right side. That's caught inside the 20. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Doug Baldwin, 72 yards. And the Seahawks have once again taken the lead. Well, that was the fly route for a touchdown. And since he caught that one and scored it, I got to tell the story. Before the game, we were standing there. He was running deep routes, dropped one. It bounced up and just hit me right in the gut. I said, come on, man. But there was no drop.
Yeah, you okay now?
I'm good.
All right,
good.
We got the ice pack up here. You're just fine. What I loved about it was the subtlety of the route, because everyone knows he's fast. They're going to play him for that route first and foremost. But sometimes it's a head fake. It's varying your speed off the line of scrimmage. It's giving the defense
sure the
different angles to think about. Is he going inside? Is he going outside? And then, as you noted, he just took off past him. Oops, there he goes again.
Is it really not blurry?
They'll throw on first down here with Palmer. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Well, switching gears on the walk into the stadium, you and I were still talking about Zeke Elliott. I mean, what a start. The guy turned 21 just a few months ago.
I thought this was a passing league, and we're talking about running backs. Isn't it nice, though? Kind of takes me back a little bit. But it's not just him. How about LeSean McCoy in Buffalo in the year he's having? DeMarco Murray has had a revival in Nashville. And don't forget, David Johnson in Arizona, a true all-purpose back. Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Now it's Palmer. And now this one's intercepted. A third interception for Palmer. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety Cam Chancellor. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
They come out five wide. Three of them to the right side. Here's Wilson. And left side here, it's Graham. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. It's a gain of six on the play, and it'll bring up a second down. And good to see Jimmy back out there moving okay after the ruptured patella in Week 12 last year. You've dealt with that injury, haven't you?
I have, and let me tell you, you know that expression, I feel your pain? I felt Jimmy's when it happened. Now, mine didn't happen quite the same way his did. His happened in the line of duty. He was playing in a game. For me, I was just coaching. And went up to try and catch a pass. I think for me, it was just mainly age. For him, he was actually playing.
But good to see him back out there healthy. They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and six. On third down, Wilson. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
Even incompletions have their place. A beautiful deep attempt. They were unable to connect, but now the defense has to think about that the rest of the game.
On is Hauschka now for the Seahawk field goal. This a 40-yard attempt from the left hash. And this one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. It's a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they get the field goal near the end of the first half to expand that lead.
Yeah, that's got to feel good, but they can't let up. Now on the kickoff, they've got to make sure they don't give up a big return or big yardage to set up the other team for one last chance to score themselves.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Here we go. One,
eight, ten. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
No.
So second and ten here. Second and ten now, and it's Palmer. He's going to try and go deep again. And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown.
Just time.
Michael Floyd, as the first half is winding down. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am, go ahead and tapping out the first half. There's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he is out of bounds here on the return. Three tight ends.
Damn.
And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. So on second down,
I can totally make that look at the thing.
No.
So they try to get three before half.
Thank God I faked it.
Yeah. And he'll try and throw here on the fake. And all the gamble fails. It's incomplete.
Well,
there's two sides here. I guess you could pinpoint and look at the offense and say, oh, man, what a disaster. Hey, the defense, though, they came through.
Preparation's the key to everything. And when you're on the defensive side of the ball, and especially teams, you prepare for plays like this.
You hit it far.
They were actually able to win it.
So that would have been something from that distance, but to no avail. Comes up empty as we have reached the intermission. As we send you on down to our studios in Orlando, we're standing.
Okay, yeah,
so Larry apparently giving us the silent treatment all of a sudden. And we're going to skip ahead to quarter number three. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you. Strength throwing the football downfield has never been an issue for this big guy. I still remember the first time I met him. He was playing for USC, and when I got introduced to him, I thought I was meeting their starting tight end, not their starting quarterback.
Such a presence, Carson Palmer.
Very much so. He's had it ever since he entered campus there and still has it today.
So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
I guess they figure with a guy who is that hot downfield, who knows how to get the ball into the end zone. You throw it up and give him every opportunity, even though that one fell incomplete.
Yeah, he's already been in the end zone many times. Trying to target him again deep there, but unsuccessful. Now it's Palmer. He's got time. He's going to take another shot here. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete.
Pass interference. Offense.
So pass interference, and partner with all the rule changes. It is hard to be a defender in the pass game.
Brandon is tough in college. It's a lot harder in the NFL. You can't touch him after 5 yards downfield. You can't touch him while the ball's not in the air. You can't touch him at all until the ball is at the receiver's hands. Very difficult to be a defender in today's NFL.
What the fucking do?
Let's go, let's go.
Palmer gives to Johnson. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed, and that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position.
We're going to make
those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Did I pick something? You didn't even pick something yet. Oh,
shit. Nope. I can't. I didn't pick something.
Pick something so you keep a play blank.
Good luck, Dave.
Watch left. Watch left. Tight end to the left. Tight end left. All right now.
What? On second down, Palmer. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Larry Fitzgerald
from 8 yards
out, and the Cardinals have broken the tie. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
All right, go ahead, do that.
Because ordinarily, the safeties are back there to prevent that happening, but they found the opening and exploited it.
Oh, come made a comeback.
Don't go with the comeback.
Now Captain Zero after the touchdown to kick it away.
Wait, wait.
Here's the Cardinals defense as they head out to set up shop. They had a clean slate last time defensively, forcing that super long field goal that was no good.
And from experience, I can tell you that, yeah, you want to block any type of a field goal attempt, but I don't know if you...
And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time.
You think that wasn't going to happen?
Picked off by the linebacker, Kevin Minter. And
his
guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
You just
and last year was sort of a tough one for Jimmy Graham. He wasn't seeing the same kind of targets he was used to. Then, of course, came the patella injury that wiped out the second half of his year. So he and Russell never really found the connection. And here's an instance where they get a ball picked off.
And the Cardinals getting
set
to try out
their house.
And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again.
Like, you have this blanket. Would you sleep on that? Yeah, no. All right.
No, we can't sleep with some screen game.
Oh, wait. Wait, 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 wait.
Get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that group.
No, that's how I meant.
We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first.
Okay. Nope. I think I actually have to, like, not control anything.
We have to do it. We have to play this through. This is bullshit. We got to play this through.
Hey, there. I'm wasting my time out for fucking this.
As they burn one here in this third quarter.
Thank you.
10 yards still left on second
down. Why do you keep playing it then? Just give it up. Your conscience is the angel and I'm the fucking devil.
I still want to play because that's fine.
No. God damn it. I'm helping you. Devil should help you. Devil should be like, hey.
Naturally, we're going to say it was a poor pass, but the defensive guys say it was just a great play by them. They broke on the football, picked it off, and gave some momentum to their team.
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. One of the newer Cardinals.
Awesome.
Oh, son of a bitch.
So we quit game.
Wait, dude.
I don't have any other controller
wait,
to
wait,
use.
Wait. Where's
the broken controller's dead too. Alright, wanna briefly just Super Sim or something? I don't know. It's one
bar. Here you go.
Cool.
Okay, do you want me to like quit? So
from that outside linebacker spot, he's able to get in there for a loss of 9.
Oh, where are we? Ice cream.
Hit as he throws there.
You're incomplete.
Jimmy Graham,
yeah.
The intended receiver, and it's third down.
Like, not like this. Calls would never go back. I want to end it with a simulation, not just guys to protect him. But on that last one, well, what's the point of us coming all the way here? Very quickly. We're not even going to see the end of the game.
And hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Going for the deep ball.
Oh, that was almost.
Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick.
Okay.
Of the game. And now fourth down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Okay, we will sim in 4 minutes. All right.
Here's Ellington. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Cardinals, great field position to start this drive as they take over first and 10. The Seattle defense getting set to go. That interception, the last go-around when they were out there, 4 turnovers.
The computer decides.
For this unit, pretty impressive.
And how happy are they to actually run back on the field? Most of the time, defenses want to get off the field. But when you picked off 4 passes,
they want to stay out.
They want to stay out there and not just pad their stats.
It goes up, bud.
And now here's another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
Well, I think it's safe to say that the third quarter's not been a whole lot of
fun. Stop it. That's the problem.
A couple of interceptions thrown. He seems to be a different man here in the second half.
Here's Wilson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Tyler Lockett was the target there. Partner, let's revisit the NFC East for a second. We talked about this last week, about how good that division is. But what about the Cowboys now, 5-1? Can anybody catch them?
I don't think that they're out of reach, but I can't believe that we're actually talking about Dallas at the top of the list right now, because let's go back to the offseason.
This is caught inside the 15. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Doug Baldwin, 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. And that will tie our game here in the third quarter.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, 1 by land, 2 by sea. He didn't mention air. Because right now, we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's 2 touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the podcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
And the Cardinals offense here ready to take over. And last time, 1 play interception. So this offense, they should be
touched. Fucking stopping.
And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a 1-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance. Maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one. Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in 1 shot.
1 shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
And on 2nd and 10 now. Second and 10. It's Palmer again. He's going to go up top again. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the All-Pro free safety, Earl Thomas. What a nightmarish game he's having now. 6 interceptions that he has thrown.
Yeah.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it. But it just tells you about the game of football. They give it, and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown 6 interceptions in a game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it 3 times. And he's brought down after a good game.
Holding offense.
X. Oh, what do? X.
Yeah, just the point. Struggles.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now Wilson on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. You know, we saw some fun things around the NFL in Week 6. You had a nose tackle, Dontari Poe, get into the end zone. Kobe Fleeter, a tight end, ran a sweep into the end zone. Interesting week.
The college game does have an influence on the NFL. Kobe Fleeter, that was a jet sweep that normally you see in the college game more than anywhere else. Dontari Poe, they use him really as like an extra tight end, and he caught a pass, really became a lateral, and he dove in. How about in Buffalo? We saw an option, and we saw a direct snap to LeSean McCoy for touchdowns.
All right, Brandon. Normally when you hear about guys making two interceptions in the game, you're thinking, must be a free safety, maybe a corner. How about getting two picks out of one of your linebackers? Again, he's just in the right place at the right time. And that's another great play to come away with the football.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I know the initial focus was on how far that pass was downfield, but how about the coverage on the play? Able to stay with him, get his hands where the receiver's hands were going to try and catch the ball, tips it up in the air, and knocks it away.
They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Play action, it's Palmer. He's going to let it go again. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Brandon, I came out of my chair on that one. A lovely looking deep ball thrown. They were just unable to connect.
Offense trying to avoid stalling. Third and 10.
I don't know if people are laughing at us.
On third down, Palmer. Finding time. He's going to try and go deep again. And this is caught. A gain of 39 that time. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
It'll be first and goal when we come back. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back to the desert. We're in Glendale.
How do you do this? Alright, you click here. There's the done.
Throw again, it's Palmer. And he'll be grabbed from behind and slung down like a rag doll.
Okay, well, I wasn't the whole lag, we keep that up.
Holding offense.
You jack shit.
Is that me?
Yeah, that right there will set him back a bit on the offense.
That was literally asleep.
Jump forward to the end of the game.
Yeah. Alright. Penalty!
Thank you.
I lost.
A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because
that was
teams
fun.
Finding ways to click. And you know people who love this game, they also love baseball.
Dad, we love baseball, yeah!
Three or four runs mixed in.
Oh, God.
The biggest joke of all.
We had fun. Yeah, we totally had fun.
Did you see the fun we had? I had so much fun, I passed out! Oh, I want to see some of the cinemas.
Oh my gosh. I won anyways. She won by cheating.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn.
Guess what, Dave? You won half the game.
Of the NFL.
You did it. Yay. Totally fair game.
Check us out at easports.com. With that, we say good night.
Look how crap
from Glendale.
But for now,
here's the bulbs all around. I don't care. Peace out. You guys like that video? Click on restart game. Because I don't want to restart this game. See if you click on the view of the highlights. Peace out. We don't give a fuck anymore.